Public transportation is back under GCQ, but measures to limit movement will still be imposed to prevent virus transmission. Our Rex Remitio is at the MRT North Avenue station in Quezon City with the latest. So Rex, good morning. Are there new COVID-19 measures that the MRT management is implementing this time around?
If you're taking the MRT, be sure to put on your face mask and full face shield. Otherwise, the security guards won't allow you to enter the station. They say these are simple yet effective measures to stop COVID-19 from spreading inside the trains. And this policy actually applies to all modes of public transport and not only at the MRT. The first trip rolled off at 5:30 in the morning from North Avenue and EDSA TAF stations. The last trip, meanwhile, is at 9:10 in the evening at North Avenue and 11 p.m. at TAF station. The Transportation Department says there will be 18 train sets that will serve commuters. But the DOTR says it can only accommodate 1 out of 10 of its usual passengers or 10% capacity. It explains social distancing measures limited the volume of passengers the trains can take. Upon entering the station, personnel wearing full protective gear will welcome you and guide you to fill out a mandatory contact tracing form with your personal details. You're also encouraged to buy your ticket at the vending machine to avoid contact with tellers. Inside the train, you have to distance yourself at least a meter away from other passengers. Also, strictly no talking to other passengers or making calls on any digital device. Contact tracing forms will be used to track you in case you were with a passenger who tested positive. The MRT management, however, assures they will thoroughly disinfect the station and trains. We have also seen buses outside the station that can serve passengers from point to point. They can take passengers from North Avenue Station, Quezon Avenue, Ayala, and TAF Avenue Station. They can also unload passengers in the same stations, plus Ortigas and Guadalupe stations. Back to you.
Rex, regarding motorcycles now, are motorcycle riders still required to use barriers when they hit the road?
Well, authorities are saying that barriers are no longer needed if the riders are living in the same house. But if one of them do not live in the same house, they have to use ANCAS-designated barriers. And the back rider must also be an authorized person outside residence. These are frontliners usually, and those working in essential services. But the driver, however, do not need to be an APOR. So for the entire list of APORs, you may check the Information and Communications Technology website. Also, motorcycle must be privately owned. And most importantly, both riders must wear a face mask and full helmet when they take the motorcycle. Ria.
Thanks so much for that, Rex Remitio, reporting live from the MRT North Avenue station.